Alright, this is like the fifth time trying this because it just doesn't want to cooperate, so I'm having to use the crappy software the camera came with, which is locked at a frame rate of 15 frames a second, which is friggin' wonderful.
I hate it.
Anyway, so I only got one game today, but oh well. There's actually something extra I want to talk about that's kind of related to this, but first, I don't know if anyone mentioned or noticed or cared, but yesterday I really didn't do anything because I couldn't think of anything to do, so I just didn't do anything. It's better not to do it than to do something randomly, just to do something, and it turns out to be shit. I'm pretty sure you'd agree. And this morning I basically said the same thing, only actually saying it, but because the sign is designed like garbage now, I know for a fact no one saw it or cared to see it. I put it in the feed thing, I basically said the same thing, and after I get back today from seeing the Wolverine, which I did, I liked it by the way, I'm going to be talking about it on the other channel, I'd have something to do here, so I do. I can't really think of anything else I'm going to do in here today, so whatever. I just basically drive ideas lately anymore. This keeps happening and happening more frequently, so I don't know what to say. Anyway, I got this one game. It's one of the ones I've been wanting to get. I used to see it everywhere really easy and cheap. I should have got it then, but whatever. It's not my fault. Other people caused this to get ridiculously overpriced. Not just this game, overall everything for this. And in turn, it screws me over and I basically can't get anything. But hurrah for me. Makes me wonder why I haven't stopped playing games because of this, but I'm stupid, so I continue to do it. But anyway, Luigi's Mansion. I love this game. When this came out, this was basically my substitute for a good Ghostbusters game. Yes, I knew about the Genesis Mega Drive one, which has its problems, but it's still pretty much the only good one. That was until the one in 2008 came out, Ghostbusters video game. It's got problems with the computer, but whatever, it's still good. It's in really good condition. Again, pissed at how much I had to pay for it, but oh well. It's not my fault. I got no choice in the matter. And so yeah, the manual, by the way, is literally like brand new. Looks like no one even looked at it, touched it, opened it, none of that. Disc is perfect too. It's like someone bought this, opened it, never played it. Hey, I ain't complaining. It's even got the brochure in there for Nintendo Power. I ain't got no complaints. I love this game. By the way, I'm thinking I might not do it because the way I gotta do it, I've already gone on about how I like it. Now that I have the real one out, I have to use a crappy emulator to do this. I might actually do a long play of this. Of course, I have to use the TV, but you know how I do it. I make it so it doesn't look like it's on the TV. Mostly, you can tell it's all straight and level. But I'm not going to be talking in it. Or if I do, it'll be After Effects, so I can do direct audio capture, which is a lot better. So, maybe. Don't know. I'm not going to be getting everything. I probably won't be doing Hidden Mansion. So, yeah. I might do it with Metroid Prime also, I'm just saying. But in that, I got to remember where certain other things are. I won't be doing getting all the fuel tanks and all that in there, because I can't remember where they all are. There's a couple of things that I think I might do that with the GameCube, but I'm not so sure. That's why I don't want to, like, definitely say, yeah, tomorrow I'm going to do that. It takes a lot of time, too, and it's also, am I going to get interrupted? You know, slamming doors and shit like that throw me off, spook the crap out of me. Anyway, the thing I want to talk about is, just real quick, I always found it funny that Luigi plays second banana to Mario, even though they're called, and let's be honest, that's what they've been called since the beginning, the Mario Brothers. But Luigi's always playing second banana. I always thought that was weird, but here's the thing. When Luigi gets his own game, like this, or say the second Luigi's Mansion, which I'll probably never be able to play, by the way, it's really good. With the exception being Mario's Missing, which I do not, many other people do, don't, but there's some that do, whatever, fine, they can. Consider it a real game, just a game in general. Mario's Missing. It's on the Super Nintendo. I think it might be on the NES. I've only ever played the Super Nintendo one, and I'm only playing that once. Say what you want about Mario's Time Machine, but that's actually playable. I hate edutainment stuff. Just keep that somewhere else. When I get, whether it's bought for me, I ask for it, I buy it myself, and I buy a friggin' video game console, I do not buy it for edutainment stuff. I buy it for video games to play for fun and entertainment, which is what it's supposed to be about, okay? I don't want that kind of stuff. You make Luigi his own game, I want it to be an actual game. I ain't asking for much for that, I don't think. An actual game you can play as. But besides Luigi's Mansion, Luigi's Mansion 2, and whatever, that's pretty much the only two actual good things he was in that's only him, that I know of. He has a slightly more major role in some other things than he has in anything else. Like the Paper Mario games, you really don't see him much at all, but he does do something worthwhile in them. But the one I'm really thinking of is Mario & Luigi Superstar Saga, which I've played all those. I haven't, still haven't played and touched the first Paper Mario because it's on the N64 and the N64 emulators. But I like that he gets a more prominent role. I mean, even in the Super Mario Bros. Super Show, or was it called Super Mario Bros. 3 Super Show? I can't remember the exact name of it. He did a lot more than that, even though he was kind of a coward all the time, but still, the point is what I'm saying, I like that he had a little bit more to do in that, and he wasn't just there, you know, or he barely saw him at all. That's why, among all the things I said in that very old video, by the way, I still have, talking about the Super Mario Brothers movie, the one that came out in 1993 with Bob Hoskins and John Leguizamo as Luigi. That's a really old video, but it's still worth watching. I did a good job with it. I did a review of it, and I also did one on the soundtrack, which not many people have. But anyway, I said one of the other reasons besides the fact that I liked the movie, it's not that I didn't say there was nothing bad about it. Of course, I'm not stupid. I admitted to many things that were wrong with it. I did say why I liked it. And one of the things was that, say what you want about it, at least Luigi is there throughout the whole thing. And he actually does something useful, and he's not just there in the background. And Mario, yet again, as if with everything else, he's the lead. All you see is him, and he's like showboating. You know, he's all you see. Mario tennis, Mario golf, Mario kart. It's always Mario, Mario, Mario. When's Luigi going to get his turn? And then Luigi's Mansion came out, and that's when he did. I was really happy. That's not the first GameCube game I ever got, but it was a launch title. It was a really good one. I really like it, so we'll see what I do with it. If not anything, I'll do like a very short video on my favorite part of the game, probably the conservatory, which is really short, but it's still kind of cool. There's like one or two tricks I know in it that's pretty well known, but maybe I might do a video on it anyway. Just, you know, it's interesting. So there's that. Thanks for watching and listening. I will see you now on this one, probably a little bit later today. I really can't think of anything else to do in here. The other one, yeah. But other than that, I ain't got much else to say. So, adios.